Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today's update is all about thermal footage and what I found today. But first, what do the experts say? The magma is at so little depth now that the GPS system cannot detect it anymore. And the experts say that it is hours rather than days. And then we had this magnitude 4.5 earthquake this afternoon by Lake Klevarvatn. And the experts say that it was a land uplift that triggered it. And the overall seismic activity has been actually moving to the east. And since we are getting so close to the eruption, today might have been my last chance to find something out. And those of you who watched my first thermal drone tour, you noticed that I had some problems with the drone range. But I did know about this hill that could have helped me. But it turned out to be out of range for my car. So a friend of mine drove me there today. And it turned out to be one of those adventure tours that we will talk about for some time. And lucky me, he had diff lock on his car and other features for Icelandic mountains. And we needed that whole package today. The first destination was a platform to fly to Keilir. Again, I ran into some problems with the outside temperature. It was too warm. This is actually something that we need to do in the middle of the night or early morning. But I had this chance today to get to this platform and I used it. And when I got to Keilir, the first thing I noticed was this hillside. It's the south side of Keilir and the temperature in the drone was telling me that it was 50 degrees Celsius. And this one is quite tricky. The sun was shining, but on average this was around 25 degrees above the surrounding area. Or enough for me to send a screenshot to the meteorological office. And then I turned to the south along the magma dike and flew along it almost all the way to Merardalir, where the last eruption took place last year. And I didn't notice anything strange on that way. I was looking for like strong signals, something that might indicate that the ground was about to open up, but I didn't see anything of that sort on the way to Merardalir. And around there I could instantly see some strong signals from far away actually, but this was as close as I could get. And I would actually need to go there again from the other side, from the south side of the peninsula. But it's easier said than done. But if the eruption won't start in the next 24 hours, I will be there. Because those red spots are quite strong, and this was a risky flight for the drone, going so far away. And after it landed, we drove further south, as far as we could go, and then we found some steam coming up from the ground. So I checked it out with the drone, because we felt it as a good idea to stay away from this hot place. So I reported this to the meteorological office, and asked them if they know this area. It is possible that this is just normal, so the drone got a good practice today, and I would like to go again during night time, but I'm not sure if we can make it tonight. This was actually a busy day. We visited the westernmost part of the peninsula. The aviation code above that island was placed on code yellow while I was doing my last video, so I knew instantly that I would need plenty of videos from there to cover that properly. So I have plenty to show for after a day, but I'm not working at home now. I'm at a friend's house. He won't be able to use his kitchen table for some days while my computer and stuff is there. But that is just how it is. It's good to have friends around to help out. And while my sound studio is in his kitchen, the sound quality will suffer a bit while I do my reports from Reykjavik. What we will witness in the coming days is an eruption that might be larger than the one in 2021 and 22. That is a general message from our experts, and I believe them. And when most of the startup excitement is over, I will give myself some time to process the videos that I've been shooting recently fully, since I simply don't have time to do the fine details when things are happening so fast. But I'm sure you understand that. Those are strange times, and just an hour ago I got the news that electrical conductivity in the water in the river that flows from beneath the glacier above the Volcano Katla is still rising, So this might be a very busy summer for me, but that's fine. I can handle that. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the Volcano Island, Iceland.